Thank you, Mark.
Dava and John, thank you for inviting me, and thank you for that introduction. I love this partnership between the Media Lab and the New Morningside Academy for Design. Really special. It's great to be here today to welcome all of you to Gen AI Plus Creativity Symposium as part of Gen AI Week at MIT, how AI is shaping the future, evolving education, healthcare, commerce, and of course today, media. By my count, there are already over 20 AI centers at MIT and more being started. CSAIL itself is 60 years old this year, and the Media Lab has been doing AI since it started in 1985, and today, Life with AI is one of its overarching collective areas for research with dozens of projects. By the way, it'd be easy to think that Gen AI just started in November of 2022 with ChatGPT, which was the fastest growing product in history, 100 million users in 2 months, I think 300 million in its first 6 months. But with it, AI awareness and usage obviously crossed the chasm, but the technology's been building for decades to get ready for this moment. In fact, I was a student here at MIT in the 70s, and I took Patrick Winston's beginning class on AI, 6034, maybe some of you did as well. What I most remember is he used to leave all the tests and the answers in the library, and he used to warn us that the exam questions were the same every year, but the answers changed every year. And that's never been more true about AI, frankly, than it is today. In the 1980s, I was crazy enough to be an early employee of a company in AI computer vision that used multiple cameras to try to recognize moving objects. But frankly, the technology was rudimentary. It was not really ready for prime time, and then we hit this AI winter, I think, as most of you know. But then 20 years later, in the early 2000s, the industry reemerged. We had enough data, we had enough compute to start to make machine learning work. Google could use data to rank search, and Amazon could use data to make recommendations, and businesses discovered at this starting point that they could use AI to do things like, you know, rank sales leads and figure out who was actually going to close. And then in 2012, ImageNet became the first deep learning product to use neural nets to recognize objects with a high level of certainty. And as a result, in 2013, as John and David were saying, in my J job, we started Zetta Venture Partners, named after Zettabyte, the start of the Zettabyte era. And it was the first venture capital fund dedicated to AI. And this month, we actually turned 10 years old. And over the past 10 years, AI has seen just amazing growth. I mean, we've gone from about 150 research papers a month to over 5,000 research papers a month. Venture capital was about $2 billion in AI in 10 years ago, and now it's well over $120 billion. And that ImageNet product that we talked about was 62 million parameters. And today, I think ChatGPT-4 is rumored to be about 1.8 trillion. So if you think of that amazing growth of technology use. And Gen AI has seen some amazing commercial breakthroughs. I mean, just a few. AlphaFold 2 was perfected by DeepMind, predicted protein in the human body, and became the starting point of sophisticated AI in life sciences. Transformers became the basis of all large language models. Diffusion technology, which you see a lot here in the Media Lab, arrived to lead us to better AI-generated images, and GitHub Copilot was used by large language models to auto-generate code. And I like to say that three big things have happened. One is, it used to be that we would create and the computers would QA. But now they create and we QA. Gen AI has basically reduced the roles. It used to be that we had to write in their language, and now they take input in our language. So we've had a UI revolution as well as an AI revolution. And the other thing I would say is that large language models have let them start to create applications that go beyond what humans can do. But given those three ideas, it's really not that simple. And I believe the Media Lab has got it right, which is it's not about what AI can do and it's not about what humans can do. It's about what both can do together. Better artworks, better music, better film and video production. And these are just the start. you know, the Media Lab is already looking beyond Gen AI to what we like to call interactive AI. You know, the idea that there are sophisticated agents that will be the next wave after copilots and after generation chatbots. They'll act and learn to perform consumer tasks, business tasks on our behalf, often without us even really knowing what they're doing. And so the important thing that the Media Lab's putting in is adding in the ideas of ethics and responsibility and making sure that these systems act in a proper way so that society can move forward well. You know, we're gonna hear today, as John and David were talking about, from faculty, from students, from experts, guests, and it's gonna be a fantastic morning. So thank you for being here, and we're in for quite a treat. Thank you. David, are you coming up next? Thank you very much.